Hey everyone. In this Gauss elimination example video, we are asked to solve the following 2x2 matrix using Gauss elimination, which means we need to solve for our two unknown variables, x and y, in the following system of linear equations. On the right here, I have placed the steps that we will follow in order to solve a system of linear equations using Gauss elimination. I recommend that you pause the video now and try to answer this question on your own first, and then validate your answer with mine. Okay, so let's get right into the problem. Through these steps, we will create an upper triangular matrix, which looks something like this. And then we will use backward substitution to find the variables that are currently unknown to us. So, we are basically just isolating one of our variables, and then using that to solve for our other one. So, to solve this, our first step says that we have to create an augmented matrix, which separates our coefficient matrix and our constant or scalar matrix like so. Now, in order to solve this matrix using Gauss elimination, we need to transform this equation into an upper triangular matrix, which means that we need to turn all elements in our matrix below the diagonal to zero. Then, we will use backward substitution, as I said before, to solve for the remaining variables. So, we need to turn this 4 here into a 0. To accomplish this, we need to perform some row operations. The easiest way to do this is using the following scaling factor equation. Let's say that we want to make this element 0. We take this value, minus our row that we are not changing, row 1 in this case, then multiply this by our scaling factor. This will set this number to our initial one, ensuring that we always get 0. Then, we must complete the same calculation for the remaining values in that row, with the initial scaling factor always staying the same. The scaling factor works as we are not actually changing our equation. Think of these two equations here. They are the exact same. Just one of them has every variable, or every value, scaled by 2. However, since both sides of our equation are scaled, it is the exact same equation. This results in the following augmented matrix, which is now in upper triangular form. Therefore, we are now ready to begin solving for our unknown variables. Firstly, our y variable is readily solvable, as 3y equals minus 2 can be solved by dividing both sides of our equation by 3. Therefore, y is equal to minus 2 over 3. Plugging in this newly found variable into our first equation and solving, we can find that x is equal to 3. With Gauss elimination, we can actually go back and quickly validate our answers as well. Using our initial linear equations, we can just plug in our newly solved variables, and if the left and right hand side of both of our equations don't equal, then we know we made a mistake somewhere. Firstly, we have 2 times 3 plus 3 times minus 2 over 3 equals 4. This works out to 6 minus 2 equals 4, which checks out. Therefore, our newly found variables make sense with equation 1. Next, we have 4 times 3 plus 9 times minus 2 over 3 equals 6. Therefore, 4 times 3 is 12, minus 6 is 6, and our variables also make sense for equation 2. Clearly, our newly found variables solve both of our linear equations, and thus we have solved the system of linear equations using Gauss elimination. I hope that this video helped you and your understanding of Gauss elimination and how to implement it. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.